So this video we're going to discuss graphs of inverse functions and how we can deal with a function that's not one-to-one but still has an inverse. So let's look at our two functions from before. F of x is x squared and g of x is square root of x. These two functions do undo each other. Now the domain of f is negative infinity to infinity and the range is 0 to infinity including 0. For g, the domain is 0 to infinity including 0, and the range is also 0 to infinity including 0. What we should notice right away is that the domain of f does not equal the range of g. That is a requirement for two functions to be inverses of each other. The domain of g does equal the range of f. What we'll do is we're going to take a look at what's going on graphically to see how we can fix this. So here's the graph of f of x. Clearly, this graph does not pass the horizontal line test. There are multiple places where the horizontal line hits the function in more than one spot. In fact, if we graph it with g of x, we see there is some kind of relationship on the right-hand side, but they're not quite similar. Now, if two functions are inverses, their graphs should look like reflections over the line y equals x. On the right-hand side, we can see that relationship, but there's no part down here to go with the part of f of x that is over here on the left. So what we can do is we can actually just restrict the domain on which we're going to look at f of x. And in fact, what we want to do is only look at f of x from 0 to infinity. So if we cut that off, we see we do get a very nice relationship between the two graphs, and in fact they do look like reflections of each other over the line y equals x. So what we've done is we've restricted the domain in order to make sure these two functions are inverses of each other. And so now here's what we have. So our restricted domain for f is from 0 to infinity. So this is a requirement in order for these two functions to be inverses of each other, and if we check, the domain of f equals the range of g, and the domain of g equals the range of f, so we in fact have inverse functions.